In this screencast, we're going to take a look at resolving merge conflicts. Let's open the Git window using Command and 9 on Mac, or Alt and 9 on Windows and Linux. Merge conflicts may arise, for example, when we're working on a feature branch while other changes have been applied to the main branch. As we can see, we're currently on the main branch. We want to merge the feature branch into main. We can do so by clicking the feature branch in the Git log and selecting Branch Feature, Merge Feature into Main. When we do so, IntelliJ IDEA opens a pop-up telling us there are conflicts. The Conflicts dialog offers us several options. The option to accept yours, which will apply the changes on your current branch, Main, and discard the changes from the other branch, the Feature branch. The option accept theirs, which will apply the changes from the other branch, so the feature branch, and discard the changes from main. If you are unsure about which is yours and which is theirs, note that these are also visible in the table to the left of the buttons, and the branch names are mentioned in brackets. We see that both branches have been modified. Choosing either accept yours or accept theirs in this case would discard the changes made on the feature or main branch respectively. Only choose those options if you want to discard those changes. The third option here is Merge, which we'll take a look at in a second. Note there is a Close button at the bottom. When we click Close in the Conflicts dialog, we see a notice, Feature was merged with conflict. We can click Resolve in this notice to reopen the Conflicts dialog. Alternatively, when we click the Close button, a Merge Conflicts node will appear in the Local Changes view. We can open the Commit tab using Command and 0 on Mac, or Alt and 0 on Windows and Linux. When we open the changes by clicking on the arrow, we see the Merge Conflicts node. We can click the Resolve link to reopen the Conflicts dialog. Now you know how to reopen the Conflicts dialog if you accidentally close it. Because there are changes on both branches that we want to keep, we'll use Merge. When we click the Merge button, the Merge Revisions dialog opens. Here we can see the changes to our current branch, main, on the left, and the changes that we want to merge from the feature branch on the right. There is a fully functional editor in the middle. We see that there are several changes. A removed line is shown in gray. Lines that were added are shown in green. Lines that were changed are shown in blue, with the changes that were made highlighted. Conflicts are shown in red. For each change, we can decide to ignore it by clicking the X, or to accept it by clicking the arrows. The first change is a removed line. We can ignore this change by clicking the X. We will see that the line is not removed from the middle pane. This is a mistake, however, because we no longer need this import. We can use Command Z on Mac, or Control and Z on Windows and Linux, to undo this mistake. Instead, let's accept this change by clicking the arrows, and we'll see that the line is removed from the middle pane. Depending on the number of changes, accepting or ignoring each individual change might take some time. Instead, we can automatically merge all non-conflicting changes from the toolbar using Apply All Non-Conflicting Changes. Alternatively, we can use Apply Non-Conflicting Changes from the left side or from the right side to merge non-conflicting changes from either the left or right parts of the dialog, respectively. Let's accept all to make it easy on ourselves, and we'll see that the left, all, and right buttons are now grayed out as there are no more non-conflicting changes to apply. Now we're down to the remaining conflict. Another way of resolving conflicts is by right-clicking a highlighted conflict in the central pane and using the commands from the context menu. When we accept either the left or the right, that change will be applied, and the change on the other side will remain open. When we choose Resolve using left or Resolve using right, the changes from either the left or right will be applied, and the changes from the other side will be ignored. In this example, we want to combine the changes from both sides, so we need to accept them both. At this point, IntelliJ IDEA has concluded that all changes have been processed, so we can choose to save changes and finish merging, which will close this dialog. However, as we can see from the error highlighting, this doesn't look quite right. The reason here is that both branches have added fields to this record, so we need to fix these brackets right here. It's a good thing the middle pane is a fully functional editor, so we can edit this out. There, that looks much better. We can click Apply and are done resolving our merge conflicts. Thank you for watching.